So, what do we know? Trickle-down economics doesn't work. Now, I agree with Governor Rendell that, look, I'm glad it was better in the 90s, and one of the most amusing things to me is when sometimes Hillary's opponent's campaign said, oh, it wasn't so good in the 90s either. It makes me think they missed their history class. But here's what I want to talk about. I don't want you to go back, but I think it's important to look at the 90s as opposed to this decade to figure out where we're going to go forward. And you will see what the problem is with the economy. The reason incomes are flat is that we haven't produced enough new jobs with enough new investment to turn enough things over in the economy and make the labor markets tight. You don't have to compete for labor. And I'll just give you an example. In the 1990s, we had almost 23 million new jobs, okay? In this decade, 5 million. 5 million, less than one-fourth as many. In the 1990s, we had almost 8 million people moving from the middle class, from poverty, up into the middle class. That's the American dream. In this decade, 5 million falling from the middle class back into poverty. The American nightmare. Most of those 5 million people fell into poverty while they were working. Yeah. In the 1990s, after inflation, median family income rose $7,500 a year. And it was across all racial lines. In fact, African American family income rose about $8,300 a year from a lower base, closing the gap. The bottom 20% of American earners' incomes rose in percentage terms even more than the top 5%. We were growing together. In this decade, median family income after inflation is $1,000 lower today than it was the day I left office.